Hello people. In this video, we want to look at Biscard's method of treatment of venous ulcer, guys. So here you can see the venous ulcer. Here you can see it is around the medial malleolus. This seems to be the right leg, isn't it? So how do you know it's a venous ulcer? What are the features of a venous ulcer? So typically they are situated above the medial malleolus, right? So basically what they are saying is this is something to do with the great saphenous vein, right? That's why it is above the medial malleolus, isn't it? So how are these ulcers? They are oval. They are small, they are painless, look at this, they are painless, superficial they are, with pigmentation all around. Okay, so let's make it oval, small oval, painless, superficial, with pigmentation all around. What will this pigment be? Yes, it will be hemosiderin, isn't it, deposit, because of the venous stasis, blood stasis. So you know about varicose veins. So one of the complications of varicose veins is this ulceration, okay. If you don't know about this varicose veins and all, you'll have to go read, okay? So here we are talking only about Biscard's regimen. So you know that how these ulcers will be. They are dilated veins above the ulcer. Give clue about the diagnosis. Above the ulcer means where? Here. So you will see that there are dilated veins above the ulcer. It will give you a clue to the diagnosis, okay? So why won't these ulcers heal, guys? Because these people have ambulatory venous hypertension. They're always standing. So what happens? The blood is not able to return to the heart. These valves would have become weak, or they can even be absent at times. And also the calf muscles, they are supposed to contract and relax and pump the blood back into the heart. Because of long standing, not enough movement, it can happen that the blood is not able to return to the heart. So that will cause venous hypertension here. That will lead to non-healing. So why won't it heal? Because of ambulatory venous hypertension. What hypertension? Venous hypertension. Perivascular fibrin cuff resulting in poor diffusion of oxygen to these tissues. So there is poor diffusion of oxygen to these tissues. So again, there is no healing going to happen. So let's blame oxygen. Oxygen is less for these people. White cell trapping. So there is something called as a white cell trapping. A lot of white cells are there here. Reactive oxygen species are increased and they generate free radicals leading to tissue damage. So there are what, guys? So there are reactive oxygen species and they generate free radicals. This will lead to tissue damage, okay? Then, inhibition of growth factors leading to poor repair. So there is inhibition. So what is that? There is inhibition of growth factors. You want growth factors, but there is inhibition of these growth factors. So there is going to be poor repair. So if somebody asks you why these ulcers are not healing, I will say there's venous hypertension, white cell trapping, oxygen is less, and there is free oxygen species here causing free radicals and tissue damage. And then you will say that the growth factors are also less. Okay. How will you treat the venous ulcer? Basically, Biscard regimen, the Biscard's method, this is what is important for you. Rest with elevated limb. So you will have to elevate the limb and rest. So this is very important. There are only three things that you have to know here actually in Biscard regimen. You have to elevate the limb, right? So that you will allow venous return to happen. So you put a pillow here and sleep so that the blood returns to the heart. So there will be no venous stasis. So you will elevate the limb. Then crepe bandage they have put here, you can see. So elastic crepe bandage will help in venous return. And then active exercises should be taught so that they can contract these calf muscles. Right? When the calf muscles contract, that is like the second heart, right, in the body, it will return it will pump the blood back to the heart. Okay? So you have understood, guys. Only three words you have to write. Biscard's regimen, elevated limb, bandage, exercise. That's it. Exercise can be active, passive, etc. Okay? The way to walk is with the heel down first. Interesting. Do you walk with your heel down first? Okay. See, the same thing they have written with a little more detail here. Clean the ulcer, remove slough, do not use any antibiotics, if it is not infected, don't use antibiotics. Put it in an elevated limb, okay? Rest with elevated limb. Elastic crepe bandage helps venous return. It should be tied how? From below upwards, or we can use stockings. So either you put the bandage from below upwards or you use stockings. Stockings also you can use, okay? What is the pressure gradient? 30 to 40 millimeter mercury. So some extra details are there here. If you want, you can pay attention to this. Pressure gradient 30 to 40 millimeter of mercury. Okay guys, focus here. What are we looking at? Biscard regimen. We are looking at slightly more details here. Active exercises, passive exercises they should do. This also you have already seen. You should contract the calf muscles basically. Which are these calf muscles? Gastrocnemius. Okay, gastrocnemius, Am I saying that right? Gastrocnemius, we say. And then soleus. Okay, guys. And then look at the exercises they seem to be doing. So, if you write these extra marks, you can get by mentioning the muscle names, right? Okay. So, let's get back here. So, you have to do active exercises, passive exercises. Then, you have to walk with your heel down first. Who walks with their heel down first? Because you want to prevent the deformity, which is equinovarus. What is the full word for that? Here you can see. Talipes equinovarus is the deformity. So, to avoid this equinovarus, to avoid, see these two combined looks like equinovarus. To avoid this deformity, they have to walk with their heel first. Okay? So, guys, you should understand that if this heals fine, otherwise they have to do skin graft, etc. Split skin graft they're talking about here. Then what else? So, they are talking about some four-layer bandaging, guys. When they're talking about bandage, they're saying four-layer bandage. And see here, once the ulcer heals, right, varicose vein surgery must be done. That is the Trendelenburg operation or anything else. It's not just that you do Viscard's regimen and then forget about it. Once the ulcer heals, you still have to treat the cause of the ulcer, which was the varicosity of the veins, isn't it? So, that's what they're saying at the end. So, here in this video, you're done with this topic of Viscard regimen. Hope you have understood. Elevate the limb, bandage it, exercise you should do. And once the ulcer heals, you can treat varicose veins. Okay. So, once the ulcer heals, you have to treat the varicose veins. So, Viscard's regimen, you have understood. That's it for now. Bye-bye.